Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be going to explain you IEEE 802.15.4 standard in complete details. See, this IEEE 802.15.4 standard that is specifically designed for low rate wireless personal area network, means LRWPAN. So this standard is specifically designed for low rate wireless personal area network. Let me show you outlines of this video first. See, in this video, first I'll be discussing about basics. Then I'll explain you protocol stack of this standard. After that, I'll explain you topologies with this standard. And at last, I'll explain you applications of this standard. Let us start this session with first agenda, that is basics of LRWPAN. As I have told you, see, LRWPAN means low rate wireless personal area network. So here we are delivered to create wireless personal area network, right? This is wireless personal area network, which is having characteristic of lower data rate. So here personal area network is there in which nodes can communicate at lower data rate, right? See, it is IEEE 802.15.4 standard, right? So don't get confused. See, this standard that we use it for LRWPAN, right? See, generally, majority of devices are operated at 2.4 ISM band with this standard. But in Europe, 868 MHz is available with this standard. And in US, 915 MHz of band that is available with this standard. So majority of devices with this standard is operated at 2.4 GHz ISM band. As and when you see devices operating at 2.4 GHz along with this standard, at that time maximum data rate will be 250 kbps, right? And with these frequencies which are available in Europe and US, that is having maximum data rate from 20 kilohertz to 40 kilohertz, right? But with this 2.4 gigahertz, maximum data rate is 250 kbps. So you can say with LRWPAN, maximum data rate means low rate that will be around 250 kbps, by which we will be having wireless personal area network, right? See, this standard is used for low power wireless connectivity solutions. So low power wireless connectivity solutions like ZigBee, 6LoWPAN, right? So that is using this standard. So I have seen students are thinking like when question comes based on ZigBee, at that time they are thinking like they will have to write answer of IEEE 802.15.4. See, it is not like this. ZigBee is using IEEE 802.15.4 standard, right? And this standard that is operated at data link layer and physical layer. And ZigBee is a protocol which is having operation with respect to application layer, then network layer, then transport layer, right? And then last two layers, data link layer and physical layer, at which ZigBee will be using this standard. So answer of this question and ZigBee, that is not same, right? You should understand this first. As I have told you, see, this standard that we use it for low power wireless connectivity, right? And that is what we are using it with ZigBee and 6LoWPAN. I have already made videos based on this ZigBee and 6LoWPAN in the lecture series of IoT itself, right? See, it is operated at lower data rate. So you can say you will be having very good performance with battery life. See, the basic agenda of LRWPAN is to have good performance of battery life. And it is assumed that with this standard, multi-year battery life is possible, right? So, but obviously at lower data rate, at lower power, you can have battery life, which is better, right? But here, our goal is to have multi-year battery life, right? So as and when question comes based on characteristics of IEEE 802.15.4, then characteristic is like this. See, It is having lower data rate at max 250 kbps. Second, it should be having very good battery life performance. Our agenda is to achieve multi-year battery life with the use of this standard, right? See, we are operating with lower distance communication with this standard, lower than 100 meter, right? So whenever we use this standard at that time, you should keep this in your mind. Lower than 100 meter that I have written, but usually we use this with around 15 to 20 meter at max, right? But still one can have up to lower than 100 meter. But if you go for higher distance, then you will have to radiate higher power. And if you radiate higher power, you don't have multi-year battery life with the device, right? So here lower distance will be there for communication, right? See, this standard IEEE 802.15.4 that defines a characteristics of physical layer and media access control. Media access control, that we have it at data link layer. I'll show you that in protocol talk. At that time, you'll get to know like how this layer defines characteristics of physical layer and data link layer, right? Now let us see how protocol stack is there with this standard. See, this standard that defines physical layer and data link layer. At physical layer, usually majority of devices are operated at 2.4 gigahertz. In Europe and in US, two frequency bands are given, right? But in Europe and US also, ISM band 2.4 gigahertz that is available with this standard. Right, and at max data rate will be around 250 kbps. So physical layer is defined by this standard, as well as data link layer, at which media access control that is defined by this standard. Here media access control that is done as per CSMA/CA. CSMA/CA means carrier sense multiple access collision avoidance. This protocol also I have explained in great detail in computer network lecture series. Right now, consider media access control that is defined by CSMA/CA in this standard, right, at data link layer. And you can observe here, see network layer and application layer that could be as per ZigBee 6LoWPAN, right? So here ZigBee is having some other things that has been designed over here. For 6LoWPAN also, there are few other features that is available at application layer and at network layer. Right now we are talking about IEEE 802.15.4, which defines characteristics of data link layer and physical layer, right? See, media access control at data link layer is defined by this standard as per CSMA/CA, carrier sense multiple access collision avoidance. So here our basic agenda is to avoid collision, right? And as if you avoid collision, automatically you can have better throughput of data transfer, right? See, media access control defines medium access. Medium access means which node will be transferring data right now. So that has been defined as per CSMA/CA. And flow control mechanism. Flow control mechanism means rate of data transfer that should be managed over here. You cannot go for higher data rate transfer. If you go in that case, collision will increase, right? So here we are dealing with to provide collision avoidance mechanism as per CSMA/CA. So media access control defines who will be using channel right now, as well as it will define what should be the data rate, right? That has been defined in media access control at data link layer. See, physical layer defines operational frequency. Majority of devices will be using 2.4 gigahertz, that is ISM band. Transmission power. Transmission power depends on what is the distance. If distance is bit more, then transmission power should be more. If distance is less, then transmission power should be less. Here transmission power plays very essential role. Why? The reason is, see, with this standard, basic agenda is to provide multi-year battery life of device, and that is possible only if we manage, we control transmission power, right? And modulation schemes, Right, so here modulation schemes that is also been controlled at physical layer. See, IEEE 802.15.4 utilizes direct sequence spread spectrum, DSSS coding mechanism, right? In this coding mechanism, modulation scheme that is OQPSK, offset quadrature phase shift keying. So DSSS using offset quadrature phase shift keying at 2.4 gigahertz with max data rate of 250 kbps, right? So that is how these two layers are characterized by IEEE 802.15.4 standard. And by this standard, our basic agenda is to provide lower data rate with higher power efficiency so that devices can have longer battery life, right? Now I'll explain you topologies used in this standard. See, there are two topologies that we use. See, first is star topology. In star topology, you see all the remote nodes by blue color is communicating with central coordinator. So here we are having central coordinator, which is coordinating data from remote nodes. So these remote nodes can transfer data only to central coordinator. And this central coordinator is communicating with external network, right? So that is how star topology is there. Second is peer-to-peer topology. If you observe peer-to-peer topology, in that this is central coordinator, but in this topology, all remote nodes can communicate with each other. Here, if you observe in star topology, then these remote nodes cannot communicate directly to each other. They can communicate, but via central coordinator. But here in peer-to-peer topology, all remote nodes can communicate with each other as well as they can communicate with central coordinator. And but obviously, central coordinator can only communicate to external network, right? That is how topologies are available with this standard, right? Now, I'll explain you applications. See, this standard is available with varieties of applications, right? One can have home automation, one can have industrial automation. See, automotive applications are also available, as well as you can observe this standard is applicable to agriculture as well, right? So that is how applications are there with this standard. I hope you have understood this. At last, I just want to say one thing. See, IEEE 802.15.4 standard is not ZigBee. ZigBee is using this standard at data link layer and at physical layer. But ZigBee and this is not equal, right? I have seen students are saying like this standard is ZigBee. ZigBee is using this standard, right? At data link layer and at physical layer. So that is how I have seen students are having confusion and they are writing things in examination. I thought I should tell this. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.